I'm your host, Paul Browning, and from the Greenland Ice Sheet, this is Power Play.
Welcome to episode 7 of season 2 of Power Play, a video podcast that travels the world to confront the hard truths of the energy transition. This week, my wife and I journeyed to the edge of the Earth to stand on a sheet of ice so massive that its fate could determine our planet's future. This is Greenland, home to a 3 kilometer thick ice sheet, holding nearly 700,000 cubic miles of fresh water. As this ice melts, it could reshape coastlines around the world. So why are we here? Because everything we've discussed in the previous 22 episodes of Power Play, every innovation, every challenge, every victory in the energy transition, has been about protecting critical aspects of the world we know today, places that are potential tipping points in the fight against climate change. And this is one of those places. The stakes couldn't be higher. The Greenland Ice Sheet is not just a geographical feature. It's a sentinel, a gauge of our success or failure in the battle against climate change. The challenge we face is as immense as the ice beneath my feet. Our journey began on a ship navigating the icy waters surrounding Greenland. The sight of towering icebergs drifting past was both awe-inspiring and unsettling. These icebergs are not just natural wonders, they're fragments of a rapidly changing world. The Greenland ice sheet holds about 8 to 9% of the world's ice. If it melted entirely, global sea levels would rise by over 20 feet. Most estimates, even with significant climate change, would project at least 500 years to completely melt the ice sheet. But even a fraction of 20 feet of sea level rise would be enough to inundate entire cities like New York, London, and Shanghai. And yet, as daunting as this is, Greenland is not the only threat. The Antarctic ice sheet, far larger, has the potential to raise sea levels by nearly 200 feet. But Greenland's ice is melting faster than the Antarctic's, and the melt rate appears to be accelerating exponentially. And that's why we're in Greenland. Remember what we said about exponential growth rates in season 1? They start slow, and then they get really large, really fast. Standing on this ice sheet, it's hard to grasp the scale of what's at stake. We're talking about the potential loss of over 2 millennia of history. Ice that's been here since the Pleistocene epoch, holding within it the story of Earth's climate and the story to our future. I got my first glimpse of the ice sheet as our helicopter brought us to Kalaallit Sermiat, one of the many glaciers that are where the ice sheet meets the ocean. I was immediately struck by the immensity of what I was looking at, stretching 1,500 miles to the north. A few minutes later, we landed on the ice sheet, and as I stood there, surrounded by ancient ice, I couldn't help but think of the countless generations who've lived in harmony with these natural wonders, and of the generations to come who may never know them. History has shown us how vulnerable this ice sheet is to climatic shifts. During the medieval warm period, Norse settlers thrived here for 500 years, farming and raising livestock. But when the climate cooled during the Little Ice Age, they struggled to survive. The glaciers advanced, the seas turned icy, and eventually the Norse were forced to abandon their settlements. Their story is a stark reminder of how quickly climate change can turn a once hospitable environment into an uninhabitable one. Today, we're witnessing a new chapter in this story, one written by human hands. The Greenland ice sheet is losing ice at an unprecedented rate, about 270 billion tons per year. That's enough to fill more than 100 million Olympic-sized swimming pools every year. This isn't just a statistic, it's a reality that's playing out in real time right before our eyes. As we stand here on the edge of this vast melting giant, it's impossible not to feel a deep sense of responsibility. This ice, this water, this world, we hold it in our hands. Every episode of Power Play, every conversation about the energy transition has been motivated by this. The decisions we make today will determine whether this ice sheet survives or whether it becomes a relic of what was. To the 26,000 plus Power Play subscribers who've been with us on this journey, With this episode, I want to give you the sense that you've actually been here with me in Greenland. The fate of the Greenland ice sheet isn't just a problem for future generations, it's our problem. It's our challenge, and together, we can meet it head on. The world is watching, the ice is melting, and we have the power to change the course of history. Let's protect what we hold dear, let's safeguard our planet, and let's ensure that the story of the Greenland ice sheet is one of survival and not loss. If you found this episode moving, if you care about the future of our planet, I urge you to like it and share it. Please subscribe to Power Play and join us in the fight to educate each other on the steps being taken to protect our world. Until next time, I'm Paul Browning, and this is Power Play.